Well, this is the actual detailed 727 model I did for the movie, and I want to show you the exhaust effect here live. Hope you can see it at this resolution. So right now, I've got the model in flight here against a blue sky with some clouds, and I had the exhaust slider set to the center position, which is zero, and that's turns all this off. So you can pose the model on the ground as if the engines were off and it looks right. Now as you slide the slider to the left, you're going to get this effect that looks like a white colored or smoky colored exhaust, and that's appropriate depending on your lighting conditions for a variety of things, and especially good for the distance shots where you want to show the aircraft from below, for example, creating the type of contrails we see in the sky all the time. And I think you'll be able to see it even at this resolution. It looks pretty good. Now remember, you're looking at still images here, and each one of these exhaust setups includes three different layers of animated noise, each one adjusted differently to sort of break up the effect. Now if you want it more realistic to the era that we're talking about, or if you just have your own need for a darker colored exhaust, you just slide the slider the other way and you start to get this black colored smoke. Now in the case of these jets, that's actually more realistic, because in those days these engines used to burn a lot dirtier, and in fact they would leave smoke that settled to the ground as they took off. So not a super complex effect, but it renders very well, and it renders much faster than volumetrics, and it's really nice just to have one single slider easily set up with channel links where you can have different intensities of light exhaust, dark exhaust, or turn the effect off completely. So this exact same effect is included with the low poly model I included, so you can sort of break it down yourself and adjust it as you need. Very simple.